do all the driving, and it was raining, and couldn't even see.
Hello?
Hello, how are you doing, Miss Martin?
I had it took and waited all over the tank. Every time I had a lunch, it was in a different place.
I hate that.
So my bad.
I'm okay. In Nashville, and it was way out to begin with, and then they had the reception somewhere else, way on out, and we just followed somebody.
Yeah, we went down on Friday, and we went to the rehearsal dinner at, so many different places, let's see. It was at some banquet hall somewhere, and then the next morning, we went to this luncheon downtown. It was downtown Greenville, and then the wedding was at this church, and then you left there and went to this big fancy place on another street, and I was like, all I did was get in and out of the rain, and try
well, at least
to
put
the directions in, trying to find
you. Terrible.
Oh, it is.
Oh, yeah. My sister and I hadn't called her today, but she lives in Charleston. She was out school Friday, and I bet she's out today. I just had to call her because I saw where somebody sent her a note that said we're praying that everything's okay with everybody there. You know, it's just like it's.
When she said 11 inches come down, when was it, Sunday or Saturday?
She was real worried. Her two youngest ones, which are in their 20s, they all graduated from Clemson and they went to the Clemson football game. And she's got a girl that's like 24 or something like that. And she called her and said, you need to get home or you're not going to get home. And she said, oh, everything will be okay. It just totally wiped her, brushed her off.
What?
You know, I'm in my 20s. Don't tell me to get home.
But they don't worry about anything like
that. No, they don't. They probably thought it was fun to rush down the road and if it's washing on the side,
You know what anyone's saying, telling people to stand. And you just see people out. And I'm like, really? He just wasted his breath telling people.
Yes.
You tell them to stand and they just have to get
They're
out.
They're going
to
get out I got the, and from all that driving and from this past weekend, my back is killing me.
That's what's probably wrong, man. But you know, when every time I go to Kentucky, right back here, hey, my neck, it's something about Kentucky.
You know what I did today? I bought me one of those things that go around my neck that you wear, like if you're taking a nap or if you're on an airplane. Well, I don't know. I just bought it today. I was in Murfreesboro with my sister Addie. And they had them at TJ Maxx, and I thought, you know, I'm buying one of those. I was trying to, on the New Orleans trip, I was trying to sleep, and I had a shirt right here holding up, and I thought, if I had one of them little neck rings, I could just put it over on that.
I don't know what it is, but I mean, it just.
And then, to beat it all, I went in the summer, now this is really crazy, without even checking to see how much it cost, I went and bought airplane.
No, how are you?
Well, how about y'all?
We're good. Us women complaining.
We've been in a car too much anyway, I bought those tickets, and I didn't. They had a special on Southwest, so I bought airplane tickets to go to Disney World without checking to see how much it cost to go to Disney World.
And
I haven't been in honey. Since my kids were little, and I have about died. How much it cost? Getting the hotel, getting those fast passes, and then finding the restaurants. All I've done lately for 2 weeks is go up and down that list of restaurants.
Are you flying much in there?
No, out of Nashville. Y'all always fly. Do you do that?
Now, Becky's family lives right there in Atlanta. Her, she's got a aunt. Her grandmother was down there, but she's moved up here now. And you can get some flights for like $70.
Yeah. I got, well,
out of that one. Out of channel. I think it's Allegheny.
I thought I was getting
Allegiant.
Allegiant. That's
Allegiant. Yeah.
And sometimes you can catch that van and it'll take you down there, won't it, Bobby? And there's something about a van that'll.
If you fly Allegiant, I mean, what we did, it takes you into not the big airport, it's one of the smaller airports outside of Orlando. We just rented a car, it's about 45 minutes drive. But I mean, save as much money on the flight.
Well, I had to find out exactly what I paid. I had to pay, and I thought I was getting a special because they run that same price. I had $157 a ticket. You know, and I told my grandkids, Mia and Ella, one's fourth grade, one's sixth grade. I said, okay, this is going to be. Mia had a birthday in September. I said, this is your birthday and your Christmas. Don't ask me for a bunch of other, don't start wanting a bunch of other stuff.
So when are you going?
We're going on Saturday when they get out the ball, This Saturday. So I've just about got to get everything together here. It's getting too close. It'll be fun once we get there, get settled down, and stick with our meal plan.
Scott.
Scott, Carlene came, Ben, would you like to have minutes?
I would like to, but I wait.
Pass a sheet around, everybody sign, too, for people that are here. This one, you want that one?
Sorry.
But I could go for me.
Oh, you have. Well, I'm going down next, right up on that, on the hill, whatever.
Yeah, yeah, workshop, just kind of conquer the hill.
Yeah, there you go, I can't even remember some of it, yeah, that's.
Stay away from the hill. I don't like the hill.
Who's next?
How are you doing, Mr. Brown?
Hello, yeah.
Today?
No, this.
Oh, just kidding.
We're a little over 2 inches.
Why do you keep reaching?
Sign off, just like, don't leave them. Hope some things.
It rains a long time, it didn't rain very hard.
No.
How's it going?
I'm good, how are you?
Well, the trees are still green, too, so we're still.
Yeah, it's a little, too, tweeting.
We're forward.
Thank you.
They're green, but they're walking.
Is everyone in that?
Everything.
Shade trees?
Anything you got.
I went on red for, I bet y'all haven't grown those in.
Yeah.
You did?
Yeah, you can sell some of them, yeah.
I wouldn't either, we don't have to cut too many of them down here, y'all.
It's job security, so that's right.
I do grow real fast, but first time the wind blows real hard, they're gone.
Oh, when they get about 6-7 inches, you can cut them down, which you know, pretty.
Yeah.
I bet.
Are people saying to pop?
I had 8 that kind of lined my backyard, and back, what was it, 12, 9, 7. About 7 years ago, when that tornado came through, it took. One of them that's right next to the house, I've trimmed that thing about 4 times.
And they grow fast.
Did it bust good?
Huh?
Did it bust good?
No, it didn't do anything. It was between our houses, but the other ones were.
Had no protection.
Yeah, had no protection.
Yeah, where I live, Joel Harris saw one of those lots, and he bordered everything, every lot, he lined it in those trees, branches. And you can kind of see where everybody's property is by the branches, but they're gradually all falling down.
Agree when they want it, they just grow too fast.
They need to be trimmed about every 3 or 4 years.
Hard.
It just hit them hard.
Maybe no funeral homes do that, but I'll keep.
I know, I saw that.
If you don't stay on top of it, you need to.
I think I just trimmed mine last year, and it's already back out there.
Carlene's not one of them. She sent me a text and said, she had a chance to go forward with comm, it was on fall work, emergency, such option. And I said, I'll blame you. It wasn't at this meeting, it was. Okay, it's comm, I'll call the meeting to order, and you should have received your minutes from Carlene through email. Okay, have a motion to approve, and have a statement, okay, all those in favor? Anyone against? Minutes approved, okay, move right along, we don't have Derek with us, so Bob will give us an update.
I've got a report.
Okay.
And I'll give it to you.
I passed by the Urban College School yesterday, but I didn't stop because I was on my way to the funeral, the burial.
Friday, like I said, he's been on vacation. He said he'd try to make the next one. And, this is kind of where we're at. He sent this to me today with Bobby Ray, which site works left in. They've got the ramps, stairs have been installed. The roof is pretty much not all the way in the drive on the new part where they laid the blocks. I think the block laying is complete where they're going to put the new bathrooms and the new corridor area where they come in. They did put a, maybe if you go over there, you'll notice a canopy goes around the, connecting the canopy to the existing canopy around the gym where kids have to walk, try to keep them out of the rain, out of the weather. And that's, that'll come down. That was just reused some used materials from the high school there just to kind of keep them in the dry. The brick work, I don't know if they've started laying the brick. He said the some of the brick is underway, but I was over there the other day. I didn't see a whole lot going on with the brick work. Material section, shop drawings have been, you know, taken care of there. Any repair drawings that were messed up, they got that taken care of. I think they had some with the rain. Fire rating ceiling is in, and the locker rooms where it was up under the bottom of the locker room where they had to go in from the bottom side and take the ceiling part off, put fire rating ceiling in, just to renovate under the bleacher. Well, it's under those big bleacher areas there. And the roof installation upstairs. High school building's moving pretty good. Roof decking and some of the roofing's in place. Piping, they did have a little issue with one of the pipes with for fire protection. They had a leak in it when they connected it and had to shut it down for a little while, but they got it repaired. Foundation beams are in place on the athletic building. That's the, if you go out there and look, the grade on the flooring is down, and then you'll see strips that run across on the ground, and that's concrete and steel, but it ties the building together underneath. So that's what we're talking about with the grade levels. The steel should be coming in this week, and the block work on the addition is complete, so they should start the brick work and put in doorways and things like that. So that's moving pretty good. So hopefully, well, before the rain started, you go out there with the multi-purpose building. Hopefully, it'll be complete by the end of October. So that's the goal. Now I don't know what this way. Urban College is the foundations were all in place. They poured the gym floor area, got it cured, and I don't think they poured any classroom space yet. But they've done the materials and color selections. They mentioned that 90% of the floor slab from the board, so they must have poured a little bit more at some point. Tie into existing buildings near completion. They had to take some of the building off. They had a little trouble with that. Just where it's been tied in for, but where they're going to tie this one in, it won't be a lot better. Preliminary grade work on the back side is complete. All the drainage retention ponds, septic system, they've already tied it, ran the pipes over there to switch it if need be. Storm drainage seems to be good. And like I said, septic system, installation's underway, but they've already. The old septic system in the front, they ran a pipe over to the new, but they need to switch it over. On track, no change orders. We haven't used a lot of our contingency money with just a few little things we had to change there. We haven't had any change orders today. Don't expect any.
I passed by there and I didn't stop, but it looked like a lot of work going on.
Yeah,
all around the place.
Yeah, there's a lot of work going on. Hopefully, we get it. The goal is get it dry, you know, this winter so we can work on the inside, especially during college. And over fall break, they'll be doing some gym work on the inside of the gym for Bobby Gray. So,
Is the money on the place which one? Any of the schools? So he got all that septic tank issues off and covered up, I guess.
Yeah.
You know, a lot better in college.
Oh, yeah.
And you know how that was a big surprise there last week.
Yeah, oh, the cistern and the septic tanks that they found, the yellow's all been filled in.
Hadn't found anymore.
No, hadn't found anything else, so I don't think we found everything and covered everything.
Underground.
Yeah, taking care of everything, but everything's actually very good, man.
They got that much concrete for it, they should be down to just build.
Yeah, they should.
A lot of surprises coming for them.
Yeah, they should come on up out of the ground now.
I think that's gym walls, they're pretty good now.
Probably, probably been out there.
Which end is the gym gonna be on, or is it the back?
What you saw was probably the gym walls, outside gym walls. I think those classrooms are all coming down, they poured that early this week, I think they poured cafeteria maybe in last week.
Last time I was out there, they were just putting the finishing up on the gym floor.
It'd be nice, but it's all complete, we're gonna be so proud of it. Tell us about the loan.
Yeah, we purchased the property there, Mr. Barnes, and talked to us back, few weeks ago, maybe a little before that. You know, said he might be interested in selling the land, and we talked to him a little bit more. He said he'd be willing to sell it for $12,000, over 1.3 acres, so that'd give us a floor over frontage there.
Oh, it's like that little store over there.
Yeah, it's the lot right next to the school.
Get clear, bud.
Yeah, it's flat, clear, good property, all of it's road frontage, so, we kind of broke it down, it was like a little over $9,000 an acre for 1 acre, and then maybe the balance $2,600 for the 0.3, $12,000, the craze for 12.1.
And it goes straight back into the school?
It's right in where the parking lot is.
That's amazing, that's great.
So it works out perfect, so, I don't know the.
It's high, $1,500.
It worked out, we don't know exactly what the.
How much did you say?
Property.
Right.
It was when you break it out, it's 1.3 acres, so $9,200 maybe per an acre. The price for 12.1. I think it's
Probably not two-thirds.
He's been in the southern part for $12,000, so it was below the appraised value, working out good for us. Hopefully, we can see if we can use it as a drive, or maybe extra parking, or playground area. Eric's gonna try to work up a sketch, or, what his idea of recommendation would be to give to the board, see how the board wants to use that. But at any rate, the biggest thing is we can come off the highway and separate cars and buses.
Yeah, I would like to see that happen as soon as possible, because we've addressed that caution light issue up there.
Yeah.
And I think if we can, get safety rents, security, take care of a lot of that in the future. Get those buses and cars separated, because it is a safety issue there, it's awful.
We talked about doing what we do with Morse and. Was a good turn on there, put a turn of traffic in there, and slow traffic down, so we'll have to get the T-bar and see what we can do about that. The state did that at Morrison, we had to purchase the materials and then they did the labor.
Now, does this go out to the playhouse?
Just to let it.
Well, it goes.
It's
right. I mean, if the store's right here, then the lot starts right there. And it's all the way to Mr. Riggle's property.
The school corner's back there, here's the school campus, here's the store. And that actually, just almost squares that up. This is the section right here, the front store, 56 right here. So, if we could get an ambulance back here on this far side, it would really add some pressure off that county.
It's not a major, it's not like probably being on Highway 55, but that highway probably has a lot of traffic with no street.
During school hours, it's terrible, and the view here at this crossroads is terrible, coming in and going out. There's a wreck there almost every year, and it's always.
You got that other road on out there or something?
It's, you know, what can I do, and we can afford $12,000, so we had money to pay for projects, so.
So why can't you have $1,000?
Have your, and nobody's ever paying completely.
Well, that sounds like a great solution to me, that's what y'all want.
Oh, yeah, I'm glad we got it, sure, if it, this save a lot in the future, it's worth its price. Bobby, you have any idea what that turn lane cost at once?
I have to go and look at it.
I know that was cheap.
No, I mean, we had to, I think, purchase a little bit of, if I remember correct, on the wide of the road, there was a little bit on the side of the property. That, you know, reverse end, which is a section that went over the right of way. So I really don't know, I can't remember what it was said. I think they were, I'm almost certain that they, we would turn buses or cars in there. You know, we had to turn it on, it was T-line, it was a turn on. We did the same thing at the same time, too.
So all three places has work going on pretty much at the same time, because there's different contractors working in all three places.
Well, same has, two of them. Yeah, the multi-sport facility, the weight room, and then Robbie Ray. Roman has, or, so yeah, they've got, you know, they're using some, there's some of the same subs that overlap. The block line and things like that. Yeah, there's, yeah, there's.
Any discussion or questions? Any questions before we go, or how much about that?
It's good, it's good, I mean, they've painted the ceiling, painted the upstairs, got the bleachers done, and the upstairs. So they've got what they can do, while we can still use it, and use the floor.
Would they be able to still do that with the, with the Good Brothers Play, city?
Oh, yeah, yeah, we're still using it, yeah. And JC's are going to be able to use it for basketball. And they had the intramural league over there, so they're using it for PE. So they'll be able to use it.
They're not going to put the new floor down for next summer.
Right.
I guess that's what I was thinking, it wasn't quite, wouldn't be ready for all this.
Yeah, no, they'll.
It's still in use.
This summer, that's when they'll take out the old bleachers and put the new floor down and finish it. So they're doing everything they can do to get that done. But that'll be the last time.
Bobby, I'll discuss with the school board meeting, some work that will be done to do with.
We're going to put it out for bid, probably next week, and, so leave us on the hook side, I think, and some of the drainage part of that road, as you go behind the school, and go left there in that road, where it drains off the hill, where the hill is washing, we're going to try to solid that, and put topsoil in it, solid it, recraft the drain part of it, where it won't wash out, and then I think leave us on the hook side of the road, and chip part of the road, so get that done, and it just keeps washing out.
Were they supposed to finish that themselves?
Well, it was supposed to have been some, it was supposed to have been some, and I think it was some. It just, you know, grass and probably.
It's pretty steep, it's not got no topsoil, it's just going to have itself, so.
And I think it was, and if I remember right, they put that seed and burlap on it, and it just didn't hold, and it seems to be solid, so we're going to put that out for bid and try to get that done.
I was So those are good as far as security?
Security, safety, good. SROs have done, have completed a safety survey of all the schools and given that to us. We've kind of gone through that, started some things to improve safety, just like cutting back hedges and trimming bushes. And we've got a safety grant that we get every year that we're replacing radios and cameras. And so, kind of upgrading those things.
Did attendance approve increase and all that for everybody?
I think we've been maybe about 100 more, not total, I mean total all year. We've got about 100 more, I think our attendance is about 6,600 total for the country as well.
Thank you.
Hopefully, Derek will be here next month.
Okay.